Hi everybody, today we will start working on a new topic that are the structural elements in CODASTER. We will start with the beam element, going to modelize a cantilever beam. We will have to put the geometry. The first point of the beam is in zero, while the second one will be in a position of 1 meter from the first one. Apply and close these two points. We will connect them with an edge. Apply. This edge will be our beam. We will go to create some groups on it. So we will go for the first group that is the fixed end. Fix. Add. Apply. The second one will be the place where we will put the vertical force, so force, add, apply. Then we will go for a group for the whole element to define some characteristics, apply and close. Everything is okay. Here we will go for meshing. Here we will go to create a mesh. The algorithm automatically understands that we are speaking about 1D modelization. We will go for a wire discretization of a local length of 100 millimeters. So we will have 10 elements in the length. Apply, then we will go for compute 10 elements. Close. We have to create the groups from the geometry to be recognized in CODASTER, apply and close. I think that here we are good. We can go to Aste Study. In Aste Study we will go to create a new stage, read the mesh, of course. Mesh 1, okay. Then we have to assign the finite element. Here we will declare that the modelization everywhere, because we have only this beam that is hidden by the axis. Yes, phenomenon will be mechanical, and we will go for this modeling. This pu de E is the Euler beam. This pu de T, for example, is the Timoshenko beam. There is also the multi-fiber beam. There are many formulations. We will go for the simple one, the Euler beam. Okay. Now it is very important. Afekara-LM is where we will declare the properties of the section. For example, poutre in French is beam. So we will go to declare the properties of the beam. The section, we will have a square section that is a rectangular section. But we can also put a circle section, or a general section where we will have to put manually the area and inertial characteristics of the section. So we will go for a rectangle. We have all these values to complete. We can go here to the documentation to see actually what they mean. We will go for a beam here, and here there is a description of all the values you can input to describe the actual section. Here we are, and here there are every, let's say, name. We will go for a square, so we will only put the H value. So carat will be H, and then value it will be 100, for example, and oh, sorry, no, we will go here and we will say that in group one, that is the whole beam. I put this name that is not so beautiful. Okay, so we will give to that group the characteristic of the beam we want. We will define a material that will be a linear isotropic material like steel. and we will assign this math, and we will assign this material then to the whole body, to the model everywhere. Yes, material created. Okay, now we have to put the boundary condition and mechanical load. We will have enforced off. We will go here to put group of nodes. We will go for fix, and we will give to fix the liaison encastre. That means that you are blocking every degrees of freedom of this node based on the element. And then we will go for a force force nodal, that is force on a node, where we will put a group of node. We will put the group we defined before with minus 100 kilograms, that is 1000 newton. Okay, now we will go for the analysis, static mechanical analysis, where we will have the structural element and the material field. The model, we have to specify the force we created, okay. And then we have to do some post-processing. We will go as usual as with the CalcChamp, with the reuse, so we will enlarge the ResLin data structure with Contrante. Here we will go for FJ Noeu, that are the generalized efforts of the section, and the SIPO Noeu, that are the maximum stresses calculated in the section we defined. And it's okay. Now we'll go for output, set output results. Here we will say the name, and we will call it 1D beam. Save. Okay. Then the result we want is ResLin CalcChamp, where we have also the field we created, and we have to chum with that. Means that we want to print all the fields we calculated. So now we go to solve the computation. Okay, we need to save. Beam 1D. Yes, I would like to see here if everything was correct. Yes, here 1D beam dot RMed. Sorry, because otherwise we will not see it in a simple way with Paravis. Run. Okay, everything is correct. We can go to post-process the results. Here we will load the 1D beam. Apply. Here we can see the displacement on Z, and we can of course generate the vector of displacement to see the deformed shape like usually we do. And there are there's FJ Noël, where we have the normal force, the shear force, is the bending moment, and we have also the SIPO Noël, where, as I said, we have the maximum stresses given the section. It's all for today. Thank you very much for your attention. Live long and prosper.